Hey everyone, hi, welcome back to my channel. Today we will see how to introduce kids towards yoga and how yoga is beneficial for kids. ये हम आज हमारे वीडियो में देखेंगे. अगर आपने चैनल को सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया है तो प्लीज़ गो एंड सब्सक्राइब टू माई चैनल. एंड कमिंग बैक टूवर्ड्स योगा फॉर किड्स, चिल्ड्रन डील विद सो मच ऑफ डिस्ट्रैक्शन टूडे नाउ डेज, है ना. बहुत ज़्यादा डिस्ट्रैक्शन है, टेम्पटेशंस है, ओवर स्टिमुलेशन है, पीयर प्रेशर्स है और क्या नहीं. जितना ज़्यादा नॉलेज अवेलेबल है उतना ज़्यादा डिस्ट्रैक्शन भी अवेलेबल है किड्स के लिए. इट्स रियली डिफिकल्ट टू बी अ किड टुडे. सो व्हाट योगा डज, योगा चैनलाइजेस देयर एनर्जी इन प्रॉपर वे. दे बिकम फिजिकली एक्टिव, उनका कॉन्सेंट्रेशन पावर बढ़ता है, उनका फोकस बढ़ता है, उनका इम्यूनिटी, द इम्यूनिटी इज बूस्टेड एंड स्ट्रेंथ बढ़ता है बॉडी में. और मोर ओवर children start loving themselves as they are, they cherish, they accept themselves as they are. And yoga से उनके body में बहुत ज़्यादा flexibility आती है और बहुत ज़्यादा फ़ायदे हैं yoga के, जितना भी बोलूँ कम है. So एक important चीज़, when children are doing yoga, see that after yoga they meditate. हाँ, see for 5 to 10 minutes they should compulsory meditate. I'll give some meditation links in description. You can follow them and compulsory yoga kiya chhod diya? No. See that they sit and meditate. That is the most important part of yoga. They should not miss this. So okay, habits, healthy lifestyle ke habits bhi achhe hone lagte hain. So without any wasting further time, let's start this yoga.
To make it interesting, let's do the animal poses. The first pose is elephant pose. Place your feet a little wider apart, gently catch your ear with the hand and bend forward and start swaying. Imagine your right arm is the trunk of an elephant. Keep your knees soft and swing from side to side, enjoying the stretch. Do this for a couple of rounds and slowly come up and relax. And now you can repeat this exercise with your opposite hand. Start swaying from side to side. Imagine that you are a happy elephant. Keep swaying. After this, slowly come up and relax. Now we will do the cat stretch. Hands below the shoulder, knees below the hips. Breathe in, lift the head up, push the navel down. And as you exhale, bring the chin to the chest and push the back as much as you can. Again inhale, look up and exhale and touch your chin to the chest. Breathe in and breathe out. Do this 4 to 5 times. Slowly come down and release the stretch. Now we will do the downward dog. Tuck the toes under, lift the hips up, press the heels to the floor. Feel as if you are pushing your tailbone up and you're pressing your heel down on the floor. Breathe in, push the tailbone up. Exhale, push the chest down. Do this couple of times and slowly release the stretch. Now we will do the snake pose. Slowly slide forward, lie down on your stomach. Place the hands by the side of your shoulders and push the elbows down. As you breathe in, lift the chest up and push your navel down. The feet are together. Keep looking upwards. Stay there, keep breathing. Slowly come down and relax. Now we will do the mouse pose. Coming on your knees, nice and wide, make some space. Now fold your body all the way forward, letting your head rest on the floor. Your arms are down by your side. Relax and stay in there for a while. This pose suits your mind. Enjoy a little bit. rest and slowly come up to the center, releasing the stretch. Now we will do the giraffe pose. Come on your knees, your hand should be on the floor. Slowly raise your right hand and your left leg and try to balance in this position. If you are not able to balance, it's okay. With practice, you will learn to balance. Stay there for a while. Keep breathing. Slowly relax, come down. Now we will do with opposite hand and leg. Raise your left hand and your right leg and try to balance. It will be a little difficult at the start to balance, but it's okay. Stay there, keep breathing. Slowly come down and relax. Now we will do some traditional yoga poses, Tadasana. Stand with your feet wide apart. Inhale, bring your arms up. Interlock the fingers on top of your head. Breathe in, lift your heels up and extending your hand towards the sky. Keep breathing in this position. Slowly release the stretch. The second stretch is Triyaktadasana. It is the version of Tadasana. Slowly bring your arms up, interlock the fingers on top of your head and start bending towards right side. Bend as much as you can. Stay in there for a while. Keep breathing. Slowly come up. And now we will bend towards the left side. Bend as much as possible. With practice, you can bend more. If you're not able to bend more, it's okay. Keep breathing. Stay in that position. Slowly come up and release the stretch. The third asana is Kati Chakrasana. Stand straight, legs wide apart. Start twisting towards your right side. Your right hand will be on your left shoulder and your left hand will be on the right side waist. Keep breathing. Stay there. Slowly come in the front. Release the stretch. And we will do this in opposite direction as well. Keep breathing. Stay there for a while. Slowly release the stretch and come forward. The fourth stretch is Padhastasana. Pad means foot, hasta means hand. Slowly raise your hands up, bend backwards and start bending forward. As you exhale, try to touch the palms on the floor, but if you cannot do it, it's okay. With practice, you will be able to do that. Stay in there for a while, keep breathing. Slowly come up and release the stretch. The last stretch is Sarvangasana. Lie down comfortably on your back. Inhale, bring both the legs up towards the sky. Bring the chest closer to the chin. Elongate lower part of the body, creating nice inversion. Breathe in, stay there for a while. Slowly release the stretch and relax your legs. Now, as I told you, meditation is the most important part. So let's sit and meditate. I have given the link in description for meditation. You can go and follow that. I hope you have liked the video. See you soon. Thank you for watching. Stay healthy, stay fit.